Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Glenn Tan speaking. This time, I'm going to talk about how to control on the computer to GNV with the third-party DNS system, which means which gateway you need to adopt and how to do the wiring.
This presentation divides into these three parts. I have put the corresponding videos linkages at the below description area, just for your convenience.
Protocol gateway. Next, I'm going to introduce how to do the wiring. But before that, I'd like to make the explanation about the CAN system. And in this wiring diagram, sometimes we call CAN1 system. Actually, it is the D1 D2 connection. And this D1 D2 is just from the outdoor unit for only one system. From outdoor unit, the master to slave, and also maybe to the indoor units. For CAN1 system, it can support one system, most 4 outdoor units and 80 indoor units. And when we call the CAN2 system, it is actually the G1 G2 connection, which is only from the master outdoor unit from LV system. Again, so from this picture, you can find that we just connected the G1 G2 from LV master outdoor unit from each system. So it's connected G1 G2 and then to the gateway. So the CAN2 system, it can support one gateway. It is up to 16 systems and 255 indoor units.
This is the topological graph of this protocol gateway. And here is the model. It is ME30. And this is the detailed wiring. So you can find that this is the GNV system. And with this one, it is already connected the D1, D2 from outdoor unit to indoor unit. And from this outdoor unit, actually this is the master from the LV system. They should connect it from each master outdoor unit series connected together and then to the gateway. And from the gateway, you need to connect to the router, then to the PC, which is the BNS system. And you can find that for one PC, we can support up to 16 gateways. And one gateway, we can connect up to 16 systems or 255 indoor units. For this gateway, we support Modbus or BACnet. For Modbus, either RTU, this apply RS485 connection, or the TCP, apply the Ethernet cable. Or you can use the BACnet for connection. And this is the certificates. And as for the detailed wiring on the gateway, and here is it. And this is the appearance of this gateway. Those of the ports, right? But actually, you just use a zero. First is this one. It is for the power supply. And when you connect to the GNV system, just connect to here, the CAN signal. If you apply the Modbus RTU, which is this one, you need to use this RS485-1 port. And if you apply the Ethernet cable, which is this 2 protocol, we use this port. After that is to do the commissioning from the PC to the gateway and the GNV system. If you apply the Modbus RTU, which is the RS485 connection, actually it is only 2 wires. And here is the detail how to do the wiring. And from this graph, you can find that this part is the GNV system is already commissioning, which means already connected the D1, D2,
and or located the in.dot unit address. And what you need to do is just series connected from each system the master out.dot unit, which here is the detail. And how to identify the master out.dot unit is just make it SAA to be all zero, and also change the SA2 on the master out.dot unit to identify you are from different system. And after that, just series connected the G1, G2 on the master out.dot unit, then connect to the gateway here. And then here is the same for multi systems and also multi gateways. And for the multi gateway, if you are for this Modbus RTU, you can combine this IS-485 together and then connect to the IS-485 converter, which is this one. Actually, this one, if you choose to purchase from our grid, we can offer you these two models. And the output is USB or the RS-232. And you can also prepare on your local market, which means you don't need to purchase from our grid. And after that, you can connect to the PC, which is the BNS system. So in conclusion, just connected the GMV system from the master out.dot unit to from CAN communication to the gateway, and then from the gateway connect from the IS-485-1 this port to the converter, and then from converter to the PC. If you apply the Modbus TCP or BACnet IP, these two protocol, which means you apply the Ethernet cable for connection, and here is the detailed wiring. So just compare with the previous IS-485, you can find it. For this part, the GMV system, it is completely the same, which means you need also need to connect from the master out.dot unit and always series connected together, then connect to the gateway. And from gateway to the router, this is different. And because you apply the Ethernet cable, so output is from the ETH0 port. From this port, you need to connect to the router. And as for the Ethernet cable, is for multi gateways, you need to use this router to combine them together. If there is only one gateway, you can connect the Ethernet cable to the computer directly. And then for this case, you can just connect to the PC to combine these two gateways together. And then from the router, you can use the Wi-Fi or the Ethernet cable to connect to the PC. I summarized the difference between the Modbus RTU and Modbus TCP and BACnet IP, the difference of these two. So you can find it. The first is you need the connection port is different. For the Modbus RTU, we apply the RS-485-1 port. But for the these two, we use the ETH0 port. And also for this one, it is only two core twisted pair. But for this two, apply the Ethernet cable. And the next is the converter. For this one, we use the IS-485 converter. But for this, we just use the router. Here is the detail how to change the SA2 on master out.dot unit. You just need to follow this table to change the address to identify you are from the different system. It's okay. And here, just pay attention that if this master out.dot unit, the SA2 setting is all zero, like this one, that means this is the this out.dot master out.dot unit should connect to the gateway.
And here is the detail how to do the wiring on the gateway. So you can find that this is appearance of it. You will find lots of the indicators here, and here is the dip switch. So there is a panel here, you can just pull up and remove the panel, you will see the detail. And from here, this is the LED indicator to indicate the operating states. And here is the detail. You will find that if the can, which is to the GMA system, or the IS-45, if you apply the Modbus RTU protocol, if you receive and send the data, it will flash the RX and TX. And here just pay attention that especially for the GMA system, for the CAN, which is this tool, if it is not a flash, if you power on the GMA system, if this tool LED not flash, that means the communication is a malfunction. And just because we need to hire the communication success, we require the somehow the polarity, which means if you find that this tool is not flash, you just need to replace or no exchange the sequence of the CAN signal, which is just exchange the G1 G2 on the wiring to the gateway, which is connect here, is okay. And for the others, STAT, that means if it is power on this gateway, it will be always on, and if it is working, this will flash. And this one is for to reset the setting, which means after that we will do the commissioning. If during the commissioning, if you had set any error, you need to do it again. Just use this one with the dip switch together. We allow you to restore the gateway to the factory setting, which means you can do it again. As for the backup, this tool, it is a reserve, not available. Here we come to the dip switch setting. Actually, there are four dips. The first dip is to activate the built-in resistor. It is for the CAN tool, which is for the GMA system. And from the actual wiring, there are two cases of it, case 1 and case B. For the case 1, that means this gateway is at the middle. So from the this graph, you can find that within the middle, no need to activate the built-in resistor. So it should be here. And at the tail or at the head, that must be with the resistor. That means in the case B, if this gateway is at the head or at the tail, you need to activate the built-in resistor. And that is also what we recommend. For the second dip switch is for the RS-485 wiring, and this one, and also we recommend to put this gateway at the head or tail, so recommend in the B case for this one or this one. As for the power supply for this gateway, it is 24 volt DC. I just made a picture here, so you can find that there are two options for you to select. Either you can use this one or use this round prong. And also 24 volt DC, it is a safe power use. And also this switch, the last tip. The fourth step is just for you to reset. When you just like this one, when you would like to reset to the factory setting, just change this to be 1 and then hold this button for 5 seconds. If the reset is successful, all the indicator it will be turned on. That indicates the setting is okay. And here is a heads up that this setting is only to reset the what you have done. It will not clear or you will not delete the data. As for the did 1, 2, 3, later I will introduce. It is just to activate the built-in resistors. After wiring, here is what we need to do on the computer for commissioning, which is to commissioning the gateway and the GMA system. And first step is before you connect to any other device, first we do the communication to the gateway, which is from the ETHO port. And then on your PC, you can input this IP address from the browser. We recommend the Google or Firefox. After that, on the browser, it will ask you the username and the password, and just input them. So you will enter the commissioning page, which is this one. And at this page, there are three steps. 1, 2, 3. The first step is just asking to select the protocol. We offer the BACnet and Modbus. And please pay attention that the default setting is Modbus, and which means if you would like to change to the BACnet, you need to use the restore factory setting, which means to change the number 4 dip switch, and then to hold the button to ensure all LED turn on, then it means the reset is successful. Then you can enter this page to change to BACnet protocol. After that, we need to do the gateway setting, which is at this page. That is step 2. And on this one, you can find that there are three, 1, 2, 3. And the first one is for the IP of this gateway. If there is only one gateway, please keep it no change. If there is a multi, you need to change it to be different. For example, change this one to 151. And as for the others, which is for the gateway net mark and also the network gateway, this one, please keep it no change. And after that, we'll go to the step 3. At this one is to check or to change the device ID for this gateway. So also the same, if there is only one gateway, no change. And if you apply the Modbus protocol and there are multi gateways under the same network, you need to change it to be different to ensure there is no the same ID of the gateway in the same network. And the last step is just to reset the power for this gateway. If you find that in your system there are indoor unit address conflict, here are four methods just for your reference to change the indoor unit address, which is from the outer unit PCB. You need to activate the function code N5, and this is available for multi-systems, which means only to set on this one and the system will arrange all indoor unit of all the systems to arrange it, ensure there's no conflict. And you can also change from the remote controller, and the serve message is from the debugger from your PC. And for this one, it's only available for one system, which means with one system, we can ensure it will not conflict. And if for the multi-system, you need to change to the next one and then also to do it again. And then the next is the from the portable debugger. Here, I'd like to emphasize again that before you connect to the gateway
and then all the system should be commissioning. Here is how to change the indoor unit address from the commissioning software on PC. So you can click here in the setting, then go to the parameter setting, then go to this project number config. You will find that here in this case, you will find that number 10 and number 0, it is config. So you can just change this one to set it to be a different indoor unit address. It's okay. Or you can use this one to reset all indoor unit address of the current system. If you apply the Monobus RTU, which is to apply the RS485 wiring, and in your project, if there are more than 30 gateways or the wiring is more than 500 meters for the RS485, you need to use this RS485 repeater to ensure it can communicate successfully. And for this device, you need to prepare on your local market. Here, I just make a comparison between different generation or different version of the gateways. So you can find that this is our latest one, and this two is already obsolete. And the difference is beside the size, and also the power supply also different. And the most important is the capability. For this one, we support both Modbus and BatNet. And for this one, it only support Modbus. So you have an M here. And this one, it only support the BatNet. That's why you have a B here. And for our latest one, we support both B and M. As for the upper limit of the GMV in dock units and the system, it is the same. Finally, I will make a comparison between the BatNet and Modbus. Just in this table, you will find the difference and according to your actual project. So you can decide which protocol you may choose. That's all for this part of the presentation. If you still have any other question, just feel free to contact me on my personal email address.